take the bad stand, put money in my mom's hand, get her daughter's college plans so she don't need no man. Stay far from timid, only make moves when your heart's seen it. Live the free, sky's the limit. So top, yeah. I wish I could play music right now. I'm sure it'll be blasting some biggie. But all right. Let's see, did that. All right. Now, time for some highlights. Time to get the highlighting on. I could do like this. Oops. All right, time for the highlights. Now, the highlights can get kind of tricky because you got to know where they go. Well, highlights, basic rules, follow the light. So wherever the light comes from, that's where the highlights would be. And then the shadows would be on the opposite end. All right? All right. So let's see. And still, it's the same rule of thumb is follow the curve. Follow the curve of the face. Oh, put some water on that. Oh, boy. What you want to try to do is like kind of blend the paints in. Oh yeah, wet paint, you have dry painting. Well, I did again with that mistake, so let me get back on track. I didn't forget about the mouth. I didn't forget about that. Ouch. Crack my shoulder. Follow the contour. Follow the contour. I'm looking back and forth. I'm looking at the image, and I'm looking at the painting to make sure I got the placements of the highlights and stuff, where they need to be. Putting them where they need to be. All about placement. Artistic placeholders. And when you're painting, it's always good to step back to see if everything is where you want it to be. So if you get too close to it, sometimes you just lose perspective. When you're too close, you just back up and look at where you are and if any changes you need to make. It better helps when you back up from it. You back up and just take a look. If everything is good, you go back in. Go back in and you continue. Following the contours, following the lines. The reason why I'm doing the lips, lash is because in the image there's so many different colors in that one section. Let's see.
blend this in with
rest. I'm doing that's called the gray tones. The gray tones are where the lights and the shadows meet. They're not dark, they're not completely black, and they're not completely white. They're like in the middle, the gradations. So that's where I'm at now. That's usually where the reflective light and all that stuff I was talking about come in. That's the gray part. That's usually what you go to next before you start putting the highlights in. Usually when the highlights come in is when you're at, almost at the end. I say the same rule of thumb, follow the direction. Now there's more colors in here that maybe some of you don't see, because I see some blues in here. Like blues, where do you see blues other than this? In the actual skin. And depending on, you have a certain eye for seeing different colors. Notice I'm using circular motions, I'm using curved motions. I'm not really doing a whole lot of up and down. I'm using a lot of curve in it, because now I'm trying to flesh out the actual contour of the face. So you don't see me doing a whole lot of up and down, a whole lot, no straight lines. It's now all curved. Or curling. See, all I did for do this is like some black with some water on the brush, which thins out the black, makes it get like a kind of a gray. You know? Then we can put the gray tones in there. So a thin black, like a almost a almost a transparent black. Messed up on this. You see me mess up a little bit. Oh well. You want to give that transition from light to dark. What I've found is that, you know, when you go like in a circular motion, or you can just like go in a direction, you kind of pull the paint, kind of pull it. You can kind of give that shading look, or you can go circular. That depends on you. Excuse me. Boy, please, the dozen roses, let's see. I also see some light brown, which kind of like a reddish in there. I need to be careful with that when I apply it. I need to find where the red, kind of like the reds are. Well, not the reds, but to place the light browns. Gotta be delicate with this one. This is delicate right here. Like the nose has a lot of this light brown, almost reddish tone. So I need to be careful with when I'm applying, like the chin and the nose have it right on the edge between the shadow and the light is, I feel like on the nose. I'm not gonna apply a whole lot, cause if I applied, you really gonna see it. But I'm not gonna do that. Let's see where all the reds are. The nose has a lot of red, like a lot of light brown in it. So I can be a little generous with this. Not too much, just a little bit. So a little bit up top. Just a tiny bit up top. In the world, I know that noise. Coming out how I want it so far. Not done yet. But I'm close. I'm close. We getting there. We walking. We walking. Do a little mixing. Let's see, a little bit more. More that light brown. Mix with that. Oh yeah. No way. A little bit of this. Getting closer and closer to the actual mouth. Almost at the highlight stage. You get to the highlight stage, you almost get the, kind of the home stretch. You're getting there. You're almost there. Alright. Still got the ears. And I haven't done the background yet. Blue, and then just gonna do the highlights of this blue. Let's see. Oh, I didn't even. Yeah, look for the chain. That he has a gold chain on, so that's another part that I put there. That's flat. The gold chain. So we're gonna use another paintbrush, a little wider, well, much wider, but it's the proper width for the chain. Exactly what we need. Also, I like to do like from the background forward. So it's another way I actually messed up. If you knew, pay attention. You especially like, depending on your materials, your media like acrylic. For me, it's best to go from like the background to the foreground. because with the foreground, you get to paint over the background. You can get a little bit loose with the background because you know you can tighten it up with the middle ground and the foreground. Like the nose, since the nose and the hat is the farthest out in terms of distance, you want to do that last. But the background, you want to, you know, you can do first because you can get a little bit loose with it. I don't say sloppy, but I say loose with it. Plus, you can paint over it. So if you happen to mess up, the paint you're going to go, paint's going to go over it, will cover it. So actually, I'm doing this all over the place. I went foreground to background. The shirt will be considered middle. The face will be considered middle. But the background right here, that's the background. I got so excited, I decided to do the foreground first, then go to the background. The mouth, the nose, the hat, the brim of the hat will be considered foreground because it will be the farthest, or it will be the closest to you in terms of physically speaking. With the brim of the hat being the farthest out. It would literally be the farthest out if you were to wear a hat. The brim is always the farthest out. It's always going out farther than your actual face. So what I normally would do, kind of I train myself to do this, is go background to foreground. So I can just continue to tighten it up. But I didn't. Oh well, sue me. Listen, those who understand and really, really know art would pick up on that. But for those who don't know, who aren't really hip to it, you know, I point it out, don't mind. Now I'm about to switch my right hand. So you are seeing, for the first time, I believe, me painting with my right and my left hand. Mainly because if I get real close into this with my left hand, I smudge this. So you're seeing me work on my right and my left. I'm doing this, there you go. Time going fast. I'm already 30 minutes in this. Wow, time flies, boy. Time flies when you're making art. Holla at your boy. Usually what happens when I'm done with these, I download them on YouTube, and unfortunately, they don't allow you to play copyrighted music. Because if that was the case, I'd been playing Biggie during this whole time. I'd have been bumping Biggie the whole time. I've been playing, you'd have heard Sky's the Limit already. Probably my favorite Biggie song, Sky's the Limit. And Everyday Struggle. I had a whole lot of Biggie songs. Let me tackle this. Now, in order to do this, for the image, I see pink, I see some red, I see some brown, like smoker lips. So I'm going to put down some red, put down some white, pink. That's going to be the overall color. Overall color is going to be pink. know, that's the dominant color. Then I could just go in and add the highlights. So here we go. Usually the top lip is darker than the bottom lip. Not quite sure why, but that's usually the case with the human mouth. The top lip is darker than the bottom lip. Go figure. So, yeah. And I'm not gonna leave it pink. You know, the pink is just the base. I'm gonna add other colors with it. Some brown, some red, some dark red, you know. And, of course, some white for the highlights. And the same rules apply. Follow the curve of the line. Follow the line, the contour. Follow that when you're painting, so you can give the illusion of depth, because the mouth is also a three-dimensional object. You want to give that illusion of three dimensions. So you follow, you go along with it. And look, it looks flat right now, but when you add in the colors, add in the different, you know, different tones, it will work out. The more red you add, the darker it gets. The more white you add, the lighter it gets. When you talk about like pink and stuff. Alright. Got that, so. All right, that's fine. Also, when you add brown and red, changes it up too. Some red and some brown. Makes the red darker. Almost like a rust. Like brown and red put together makes like a rust. Almost like blood. Like if you want to make the color blood, just add some brown, add some red. Like not a whole lot of brown, just kind of like more red than brown, but enough to darken it, and it will turn to a rust color. That's how you pretty much get rust. That's just a little inside something for that one time. Like, there's some cool ways to get other colors that I didn't even think about. Actually, I got by mistake. Like, when I wanted to get, like, kind of a goldish color, but I didn't have any gold, kind of like a dark yellow almost to gold. What I did by accident was actually put pink with yellow. Pink with yellow actually accidentally gave me a goldish color, not like a real shiny gold, but a kind of like a dull gold color. I use it all the time now. I did it with markers. I've yet to do it with paint to see if it actually applies with paint too, but I'm gonna try it to see if it works with paint. And since the view of this image is from the bottom up, the top lip is always larger than the bottom lip when you're going from the bottom to the top view. When you're going from the top to the bottom lip is larger. That's just, you know, simple physics. This is how that works. The nose looks much larger. The top lip looks much larger. Yeah. Let's see. Here's some highlights. Let's see. Let me just keep going until it stops, until the laugh stops. Maybe I. Alright. Add some more brown to that. Running low on the brown. Brown and black makes for a darker brown, which is good for dark skin tones. Good for dark skin tones. Don't make it too dark. There we go. Now I'm starting to get to the highlights now. We're really starting to get close. Starting to get really, really close. Starting to get to that home stretch. I haven't added the whites in there yet. The little highlight, actual highlight part. But your boy getting close. Do that too much. Follow a contour. You know, the lip itself is curved. Along with the lines here, the lip itself are curved. So the best way to give you illusion of that is, you know, you. Like, if it's curved this way, you go this way, but you also curve, like a little C, and you curve in you go in the direction of the actual lip. Here. It's so good, baby, baby. It was all a dream. I used to read Word Up magazine. Salt and pepper and Heavy D up in the limousine. Hanging pictures on my wall. Every Saturday, Rap Attack, Mr. Magic, Marty Mar. I let my tape rock till my tape pop. Smoking weed and bamboo, sipping on private stock. Way back when I had a red and black lumberjack with the hat to match. Remember rapping Duke? The hard, you never thought that hip hop would take it this far. Now I'm in the limelight cause I rhyme tight. Time to get paid, blow up like the World Trade. Boys in the opposite of a winner. Remember when I used to eat sardines for dinner? Taste the hardy, Boosie B, kick a pre. Fuck Master Flex, love bug, star ski. Blow it up like I thought I would. Creep, same number, same hood. It's all good. And if you don't know, now you know, girl. Super Nintendo, Sega Genesis. When I was dead broke, man, I couldn't picture this.
I still gotta do the background, so I'm still not done. I gotta add the stuff to the shirt.
Phone bill about 2 G's flat. No need to worry, my accountant handles that.
Let's see, I could do the highlights now. Now, we reached the moment. It's highlight time for the most part. All right, you gotta be careful with the highlights. Let's see.
I made the change from a common thief to up close to personal with Rob and Leech and a far from cheap brunch with my peeps all day. Spread love is the Brooklyn way. My wet and Alizé keep me pissy. Girls used to diss me. Now they write letters cause they miss me. I never thought it could happen, this rapping stuff. I was too used to packing gas and stuff. Now honeys play me close like butter plate toast. From the Mississippi down to the East Coast. Condo to Queens in those weeks. So thou cease to hear Biggie Small speak. I'm gonna wrap it up, yeah. Put 5 carats in my baby girl, yeah. Punches.
See, now I'm pulling. I'm taking. It's a dry paintbrush, which helps me pull the paint and give it more of that transitional blending effect. I could do it with a wet brush, but for me it works better with a dry brush. All right. So all you need like a little bit of white, properly placed, and it works. Bam. You gotta put the white in his eyes, the highlight in his eyes. That's coming out really good. Got a chin. I'm gonna leave this alone. This is already white, so I'm gonna leave that alone right here. Alright, leave that alone. But the blue. Here come the blue. Alright. I'm gonna pause it now because I'm about to run out. But let me just show y'all up close. Bam! How y'all like that? How y'all like that? Yeah. Alright.